So let us look now to an overview of the abortable consensus algorithm. So a proposer will pick a unique sequence number. Hopefully it's a high sequence number, higher than the one he used before, otherwise it will have no effect. And he send a prepare n to the acceptors. Now, each acceptor, upon receiving a prepare, promise not to accept any more proposal number less than n. They freeze the state, basically. And each one sends the highest number proposal accepted with number less than n. So they send the value v, the highest number proposal with less than n, and they do the promise, and they basically freeze the state between that number, the highest number proposal, maybe number m, until number n. Now, so they send this information to the proposer, and the proposer, upon a majority s of promises, it will pick the value v of the highest proposal number in s, and if none available, it picks its own v freely, and it issues an accept to all acceptors. So it issues an accept, which is n and v to all acceptors. Now, when an acceptor receives an accept, n and v, if it does not promise another proposal with a higher number than n, this is the case, if not responded to prepare with number that is higher than n, it accepts the proposal. An accept means it will send an acknowledgement. Otherwise, it will send a rejection. Because in this case, it has already accepted even a higher proposal number. So it made a promise to a higher number. And upon a majority of responses at the proposer, if the proposer got a majority of acknowledgement, it decides on V and broadcasts V to all processes. Otherwise, if it gets an ACK from in this majority set, then it aborts. So this is basically the algorithm at a very high level. Let us just say some remarks about it. Here we said send prepare n to an acceptor. If an acceptor has promised with a higher number to some other proposal, then it ignores this prepare message. It is fine. Nothing will go wrong. It might also send a negative acknowledgement and say, you have no effect. This is a very bad proposal. You have to come with a higher number. So this is something that is not written here that you can see. The other thing that you can see from this, if a proposer gets a majority S of promises and all have the same value, then this value is chosen. He doesn't need to reinforce this majority. It is already chosen. So that is also a possibility that he doesn't need to do that second phase. By this, we end a high-level overview description of abortable consensus.